So the great bird flew away. The years passed. Summers and winters came and went. Some years were good, some years were bad. One year was very bad.
Noggin, we have gathered in the corn.
What is it like, Master Cornkeeper?
It's poor stuff, Noggin, and very little of it. There's not enough to last us through the winter.
What shall we eat this winter, Master Cornkeeper?
Well, there's nothing else, Noggin. We shall go hungry.
Thormoxen, Graculus, make ready a long ship. Fill it with treasure from the castle. We are going to the Southland to buy corn, and we are going now.
With Graculus at the helm, Noggin and 10 strong warriors rowed their long ship down the fjord and out into the open sea. There a fair wind took them and blew them towards the south. The Southland was rich, but her merchants were mean.
Is this the corn you bought with all that treasure?
It isn't much, is it? We shall be hungry this winter, but without it we should starve. Come on, we must start for home. Winter is nearly here, and soon the sea will freeze.
No wind came to help them on their way. The long ship laden with corn was heavy.
Noggin, we must rest. The men have been rowing for 2 days and nights. They must rest or they will drop at their oars.
We must keep going if we can, Noggin. Look, there are patches of ice forming on the sea. If we don't reach home soon, the ship will be caught in the ice and crushed.
Well, we can't go on if the men are too tired to row. Light the stove. Make the sail into a tent. We'll have hot buttered toast and cheese and a few hours' sleep.
Night came. The Noggs curled up and slept around their stove. In the pitch dark, the ship lay calm in the icy sea. For a while.
Hold tight! There's a storm! Hold tight, everybody!
There! It's past. What a storm! I thought we'd hit a rock or something. Look outside, Graculus. What can you see?
I can't see anything. It's pitch dark.
Oh, well. Back to sleep, everybody.
The Noggs slept until the cold light of dawn began to lighten the east.
Wake up, you lazy lot! It's morning!
The Noggs sprang to their feet and ran to the side of their ship. Not one of them will ever forget the sight they saw.
Where are we, Noggin? Where's the sea?
There was no sea. In the distance, they saw blue mountains. And down, far below them, they saw valleys and houses.
We're on top of a mountain.
Greetings, Noggin the Nog. I hope we didn't shake you about too much. We had to lift you from the sea before it froze and crushed your little ship.
Who said that?
Look behind you, on the rock. All the great birds.
Oh, greetings. Greetings, birds. We thank you.
Prince Noggin, many winters have passed since I came to your castle. The years are gone, but the memory of a promise does not fade. I was hungry and cold until the ice had reached my bones when I came to your castle. You fed me and warmed me, though I ate more than all the birds of your kingdom put together. That day I gave you a promise. Today it will be kept. Eat now, and then we shall take you home.
What are these? Huge nuts.
They've got sort of milk in them. They're delicious.
Hold tight, Noggs.
Two of the lesser orcs grasped the spar of the ship's mast, and as if it were as light as a twig, they lifted it and flew with it down the valley to where Noggin's castle stood. Noggin told his tale to the elders of the city, showed them the meager store of corn that he had brought.
It's not much, Noggin, but we won't starve if we're very careful. Look up there.
Mind out below.
There were many, many of the great birds flying down into the valley, and each of them carried in its claws a bunch of the huge nuts, which it dropped into the courtyard of the castle. By the time the birds had finished, the pile of nuts was as high as the castle itself.
Look at that! There must be thousands and thousands of nuts.
Well, that lot should last us through the winter.
And several winters to come, by the look of it.
Goodbye, birds.
Goodbye, birds.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. Goodbye.